Hey guys, welcome to the cycle of FSX. If you want to play, you will be flying the Lockheed L-1011 TriStar.
We're not going to request a taxi out of FAR yet, because of course everything needs to be set up. Good thing they do. Delta 320. Right, heading, let's see. Right, we've got two engines. We have all engines? Yeah, we've got all engines. All engines? I wish I could just sort of... According to those, yeah, all engines are running, so request taxi IFR.
The Gaule ground, Air France 1123.
I don't know why that guy's still there.
Ready to taxi IFR.
Air France 1123, heavy. Taxi to and hold short of runway 27 left. New taxiway, Mike Bravo, Mike 1, Bravo, Bravo, Quebec 1, Quebec Yankee 13. Contact tower at 120.65 when ready.
So we're flying to JFK Airport.
Taxiing bolt short, runway 27 left.
Taxiway,
Mike Bravo, Mike 1, Bravo, Bravo, Quebec 1, Quebec Yankee 13, Air France 1123, heavy.
Yeah, I hope those guys move, otherwise they're going to be getting taken out by the wheels. Gear. Instead of the parking brake, if you don't think like you need it.
The Gaule ground, Pacifica 1205, IFR to Valencia, ready to copy.
Pacifica 1205 is cleared to Valencia Airport as filed. Fly runway heading, climb and maintain 1.4
Why does that occasion just here?
1.8.19,
clock 7016. Pacifica 1205 cleared to Valencia Airport as filed. Fly runway heading, climb and maintain 14,000. Departure on 118.15, squawk 7016.
Pacifica 1205, read that correct. Contact ground on 118.1.
Shortly I should stop the pushback. Like now. Now let's taxi over to the runway, if this bloody thing would work. Also the pushback truck, yeah, run, I got owned by the engine, and he got taken out, he's dead. 4.8 nautical miles and he's ascending, so that makes me think.
The Gaule ground, Pacifica 1205 with Yankee, ready to taxi IFR.
Pacifica 1205, taxi to and hold short of runway 26, right, using taxiway golf, puppet 1, Romeo, Tango 20, Romeo, contact tower at 120.9 when ready.
So yeah, we're doing a transatlantic thing.
Taxi, hold short runway 26, right, using taxiway golf, puppet 1, Romeo, Tango 20, Romeo, Pacifica 1205.
I really hope this is the way we're meant to be going. No, no it isn't!
On taxiway, on taxiway.
Yep. I'm just slow moding because that thing is just annoying. Oh, there we go. Now it works. For whatever reason. Now it doesn't work if you're looking at it from the front.
On taxiway. On taxiway.
No, so I don't care. I may as well be going for takeoff here, I think. Take a look at the speedometer, yeah. Yeah, definitely turn that off now. F2. Yeah, I didn't expect seeing that. Just imagine if they actually did that. Actually going to apply just the differential brakes, I think they're called. I'm staring because this is pretty much just a straight path.
On taxiway, on taxiway.
Yeah. Yes.
On taxiway,
yes.
On taxiway.
All those little particles just keep them...
On taxiway, on taxiway. On taxiway, on taxiway.
Three parallel taxis.
On taxiway, on taxiway.
Good.
On taxiway, on taxiway.
Go, you... Wait, why would you take me all the way back here?
Approaching 27 left.
West takeoff.
The Gaule Tower, Air France 1123 heavy, ready for IFR departure, runway 27 left. Air France 1123 heavy, cleared for takeoff, runway 27 left.
And acknowledge. I said acknowledge.
Cleared for takeoff, runway 27 left. Air France 1123 heavy.
Oh,
on
see.
Runway 27 left.
There we go. We're about to. I do believe that's lined up fairly well, so we're gunning the engine. I'm making use of the full length of the runway. Showing me not have passed the threshold, but. Probably would have been used on these route on this route. Just nicely, I guess. Good thing about the normal coast. Engine one. Okay, does this have first off? Thank you. you can see, this is the pre-winglet era. Alright, yeah, actually. Radio. I don't have to want to deal with communications, and I want to be able to go up to 16 times speed. Which, hold on, let me figure this out. Like, how long it's going to take? Like, let's just say this is an 8-9 hour flight. So I'm just going to go. Oh God. Options, simulation 8. No, we'll just let this aircraft settle down. The altimeter is set incorrectly for high altitudes. Well, I set it correctly. What is my altitude? That seems too steep. That's kind of bad. It can kind of handle 4 times, but it cannot handle 16 times. Oh yeah, we're overspeeding, so that's kind of good. Bring our speed back. Set it to lock. Why does it not? It's having trouble handling that higher speed. Yeah, I think this we can. Screw the huge altitude differences. Seriously, look at those altitude differences. It does not matter. So there's England, you can see. I think that's the Isle of Wight. I've no clue actually. And then you can see France, but you can't really see France because of the clouds. I love the way the wings are just. I do wonder how much out. Let's get a map view. Just watch, let's zoom out, and it's gone. So we're flying a transatlantic flight. It says 16 times, so it should. It should not take 30 to 40 minutes. Most of it. You can actually see the tail being adjusted by its trim. I'm not sure that's how the real autopilot functions, but you know. I think that's Cornwall. I would not bet on it. You know, I may be saying, I might not be correct, because I don't live in Britain. It's Britain, not England, even though technically Cornwall is a part of England. Ooh, there's an airfield. Well, that's an airport, because it's got two runways. This is the first JFK airport today. not LaGuardia or Newark or one of those.
Well, I think LaGuardia, JFK, and Newark are the main
airports in that region. Near New York, it is in New York State, it's in New Jersey.
We're definitely almost 1,000 feet. Of course, the ATC would have my head on stick for it, have my head on pillow for this specific airport.
EGTP. EGHC? EGDG. Tower. EG.
You can see the nose is almost being pushed down.
Now, of course, this is one of the trijets. And of course, both the West had, in terms of trijets, they had this, they had the DC. Well, they had the TriStar, they had the DC-10,
and the MD-11, I believe that's all the TriStars, or TriStars, TriJets, the West had.
Is the weather like here? Yes, yes, it is.
I'm trying to figure out roughly where. But we've passed my house, but the weather is like this, so. Realistic weather. And also.
Right, the trijets. The Ruskis, however, had quite a few. They had the Tupolev 154, the Yakovlev Yak-42. I think they had quite a few more. I just don't know the names of them.
I'm actually going to see. But trijets? Technically, there's another aircraft that has three engines, but it's not a jet, it's the Trilander, you know.
I'll give you the list of all of the trijets. Well, technically there is the KC-10 in there, which are the tanker versions of the DC-10, I believe.
Now, Wikipedia's definition of a trijet is... Oh, yeah, the 727 Mach 7 the trident over apparently. A trijet is a jet aircraft powered by three jet engines. Early twin jet designs were limited by the FAA's 60-minute rule, whereby the flight path of twin-engine jetliners was restricted to within 60 minutes flying time from a single airport in case of engine failure. In 1961, it was lifted for trijet design, they had greater safety margin, as they had greater safety margin. So, right. Examples. Right, there's the Boeing 727, the Boeing X-48, right, yeah, that's the kind of test flying wing one, which is three inches on its top. And the Dassault Falcon 50, the Dassault Falcon 900, the Dassault Falcon 7X, the Dassault Falcon 8X, the Hawker Siddeley Trident, Lockheed L-1011 TriStar, which is this, the Martin XB-51, which does not sound familiar to me. Well, right. It's a bomber that has two ends kind of under it and another end in the tail. Kind of, I think. McDonnell Douglas DC-10, the MD-11, Tupolev TU-154, the Yakovlev Yak-40, which is, I think, just looking at it, just a smaller version of the Yakovlev Yak-42. Actually, the West did have quite a bit of trijets. There's a different trijet. So, for example, this one has an S-duct, I believe it's called, which... The intake is here, but the engine itself is only down here, ish, I think. Let's see what else. It's interesting, they planned on making a trijet version of the 747.
hold on. I'm just wondering about this. That was a scaled down 747. So the 747-300 trijet. Downsize 747 to complete with the DC-10 and L-1011. Just cancelled. The blended wing body trijet basically is the Boeing X-48, but that's been cancelled or proposed. The McDonnell Douglas MD-XX, which is a stretch derivative of the DC-10, so basically the MD-11. North American NR-349, a proposed interceptor derivative of the A5 Vigilante. The Airbus Twin Trail Trijet, status unknown, so they've proposed about nothing. The Dassault Supersonic Business Jet, which has been suspended. The Ariane AS2. Never heard of this. It's also a planned supersonic business jet. The Sukhoi Gulfstream S-21, which is also a supersonic. Yeah, so it seems there are quite a few supersonic aircraft suggestions that have been shelved, and I would not want to be flying on this. It's facing constant turbulence. No thanks, do not be in a picture of the 727. Also, the 727, for example, it had two engines. Its engines were rear mounted, so it had one here and here. Boeing 777 was originally envisioned as a trijet. Of course, then it was a twin jet design. There are actually not that many trijets, because the FAA kind of had a rule. Because this. I honestly have no idea that they're more expensive to maintain, I'm presuming, and that twin jets can do the same purpose. Because this can only carry me. This can kind of carry the same amount as an A350 or A330, for example, I think. This is of comparable size to those aircraft. And so, that's why I think it's cancelled, because what is, of course, it uses more fuel because there's three engines, I think. It doesn't carry that much more passengers, therefore, not making as much money. Of course, it's safer because, you know, let's say you lose one engine, you still have two. And most of these aircraft, let's say I turned off the rear engine. Actually, let's demonstrate. Simulation rate normal. And of course, this thing. Yes. Oh, I've got a wrong pitch. Alright, let's shut down central. It's not, so you can see it's powered down. Altitude is working on. You can see the other engines have throttled up, but the third engine, nothing. Well, you can see it is maintaining the speed of it. Kind of barely so. I'm just keeping. There we go. We're starting to get the ignition. Which is good. We're starting to regain power in the separation. Of course, we just say that was a problem with the fuel line or something. Yes, the engine is almost up to. Well, it's been shortly once it's built itself back up to 290 knots, then it should be fine. But as you can see, it can fly with just two engines. So if an engine goes out there, they can just bring it in. Land it nice and gently. Let's go back to 16 times speed. And one of the things that these aircraft are used for, mainly for launching Pegasus launchers, which is under here, the place under here. It's used to carry those up to an altitude for dropping them and sending them off to deliver their payload. But there should be a Pegasus launch later this year, so that should be interesting to watch. Of course, you know, the aircraft takes off, it flies to a certain drop point. Of course, that's a good thing, you can fly them from basically anywhere in the world with an airport. But let's just say you want to launch into a polar orbit from... Let's just say you want to launch into a polar orbit. The only place in the mainland US you could do that from is Vandenberg AFB. And then, of course, that directly below it is the sea, and therefore you won't drop anything over countries. But I think you could, with a Pegasus, launch from, let's say you take off from New York or something, and then go straight down, or, you know, maybe fly out, and then turn towards... What the heck? What just happened? What just happened? Have you ever seen this? The engines are running, so... I don't know. Which is why... It's cute. So why are we going to do that? Because that thing just turned and plummeted out of the sky. It just turned and nosedived. Which is confusing. Well... Confusing is, I believe, an understatement. But all engines are running normally, so I've no idea why that happened. But now we're going to stay at this and then watch what happens. We're going to go up a bit above 35,000 feet, which is, of course, our cruising altitude. We're up to 36. That to me is the signs of a storm. Yep, he's stalled, so let's see if the autopilot. Push the nose down. Back to that wobbly flight path, but I've no clue what happened there. The aircraft was turned and plummeted. If any of you have any experience as to why that could have happened, like, was it trying to change and hitting and then fall? That to me does not make sense. Or did it stall? Because I couldn't see if it stalled or not, so maybe it stalled. You can see the engines are going from off to full power, so it's rarely actually at that speed. It shouldn't ever go down to the stall speed, so... No. Maybe that's what happened, maybe it stalled. And that, of course, I couldn't react to it, so the aircraft plunged. I think the right wingtip, from what I could tell, stalled first, because that was... me, it looked like the right wing dipped as it fell. It has happened that only one of the wings stalls. I believe that happened on the I'm not sure if it's American Airlines or United Airlines, but it was one of those airlines, and the aircraft stalled. Or the aircraft. This is the one, a DC-10, and the left engine fell off. This end, I think it was this engine, it kind of flipped up over the wing. Except, you know, it was a DC-10, not a TriStar, but... How are we doing with this? I'm not dropping too low. I would watch if I... Of course, I would speed up faster, but you can't with the... Not with the autopilot engaged. So technically, New York... Well, technically, if you drew a line, we're covered... Ah, but you can see we're flying straight into JFK. It's like no turns, technically. Of course, if required, the aircraft could perform corrections, but... I don't think that's necessary, so... As we approach New York, we'll contact the tower, we'll send and land. We land nice and smoothly. Maybe a bit optimistic, but... Well, guys, I think I'm just going to pause the recording here for a while, because I think... You know, 31 minutes and we're barely halfway there, so... I'll see you guys once we're a bit closer to New York. Hey guys, we're back, and now we're going to tune Boston Center.
Boston Center, Air France.
Oh wait,
Air
they're
France.
Sending!
1-2, Air France, 1-1-2-3, heavy, turn left, heading 2-5, turn left, heading 2-5-0, proceed on course, ascend and maintain 8,000, Air France, 1-1-2-3, heavy, Air France.
Hold on. Cancel.
1-2, Boston Center, Air France, 1-1-2-3, negative.
Oh, wait, no.
Air France, 1, Boston Center, Air France, 1-1-2-3, heavy, affirmative, cancel. Air France, 1-1-2-3, heavy, IFR flight plan is canceled, radar service terminated, squawk 1-2-0-0.
New York is kind of bad. That's kind of happening. I don't mean the big thing. Yeah, I'm very good at describing
Boston
things.
Boston Center, landmark 336, orbit 1882, you are 907 miles southwest, turn left, heading 020, descend and maintain flight level 2900, right. Expect vector spatial, runway 22, right approach.
You know, shortly they will tell us to descend, so.
Air France 1-1-2-3 heavy. Descent. Air France.
Cancel. Or option sim rate normal.
Maintain flight level. Orbit 1882. You are 70 miles southwest. Turn left. Heading 020. Descend and maintain flight level 210. Expect vector spatial. Runway 22. Right approach.
Turn left, heading 020, descend and maintain flight level 210, expect vector visual, runway 22, right approach, orbit 1882.
Unless you slightly deploy the speed brakes, and they can already see through the wing. Bottom bit of that is sealed.
Air
Right, runway 4 right. Not world options, sim right, normal. Unpause.
220, expect vectors ILS. Runway 4 right approach. Air France 1123 heavy.
220. I still don't know what altitude I'm at. I don't know, but the autopilot does. The nose is going up. And the speed is dropping. But I'm confused. The aim of it being done, so. Poof, poof. That does it, yes. Attracted. So we should have a tri-jet approaching the landing at JFK. What airport is this? Is this an airport diagram? It might also be useful if it tells me what it is. And another thing's pitching up. I'm trying to figure out. That's the altimeter, yes? Altitude 5-2.
Oh. Air France 1123 heavy. Contact Boston Center on 124.525.
Acknowledge.
Going to 124.525. Air France 1123 heavy.
And then my test to
Boston
descend
Center,
there, so
Air France 1123 heavy with you. Air France 1123 heavy, Boston Center, roger.
Four times. Because Manhattan is a bat.
Air France 1123
descend.
Maintain 16,000. Air France 1123 heavy.
Option 60,000. That must be. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Like, see, you can see straight through the wing. There, you can see the wheel, the gear bays. That's what the gear. See what I mean? Just watch. You can see the gear like, even though there's no actual hole there. See what I'm saying? I think this is Long Island, but I've no clue, none at all. Parking brake. We're landing with a parking brake on. Yeah, landing should be interesting. No, actually, so much. Yeah. Maybe the landing should be interesting because, you know, you guys know my landing skill ain't the best. Especially Igor. So, yeah. I'm still trying to figure out how this thing works. Is that it? Just wait, have I? Yes, okay. Kind of, sort of. I know I didn't want to say a lot. Yeah, I almost stalled that airport.
Air France 1123 heavy, your 300. Descend and maintain 16,000. Air France 1123 heavy.
Are you?
Air France 1123 heavy.
Please expedite
descent. Air France 1123 heavy, please expedite your descent. Air France 1123 132 point. Boston Center. Air France 1123 heavy, Boston Center. Roger. Altimeter 3023.
Right, you're gonna tell me to turn towards JFK? Of course, you know. That's Manhattan there. JFK's
Air France 1123.
Alright, descend and maintain an altitude of 8,000 feet and a speed of 240. Yes. And a speed of 240. Of course, we're nearing the airport. We're going to be slowing down quite a bit. Now, some people say slowing up, which kind of, to me, makes no sense. Alright, let's... Yeah, the speed brakes, let's say, here.
Maintain 8,000. Air France 1123 heavy.
I hope shortly they will give us an order, a command, or whatever you call them, to turn. Because really, the last thing I want now to happen is be flying. Well, actually,
Air France 1123 heavy.
Contact New York.
Point 123 point. New York approach. Air France 112. Air France 1123 heavy. Turn.
Stem right, normal.
Heading 250, Air France 1123, heavy.
There we go. Imagine landing this aircraft on that. It would be quite interesting.
Air France 1123, heavy. Turn right, heading 280. Right, heading 280, Air France 1123,
yeah,
heavy.
Okay. Now we're heading. Now we're starting to head in. And we're at our altitude, so quickly. Pulling those speed brakes. Okay. Let's see kind of what altitude this thing settles down. So, flaps set to 1. The slats are out at the front.
Air France 1123 heavy. Turn left heading 250.
Okay, what was the point of turning
turn
to
left
280?
Heading 250. Air France 1123 heavy.
I might understand that if we were at, you know, if there was a fair bit of traffic, but although there is a bit of traffic, but you know, for example, the Pacifica is on the ground. This thing is in the air, but nowhere near me. Yeah, it's taking a long time to load. The MD-83 is on the ground. Oh, about to take off. Huh, let's watch this. What's with the wing shape here? Airwave airline, you know. Please tell me it's not going to taxi at that speed to the runway. Please, I'm going to do my tactic and just gun the engines and take off. And where's that? Okay, it's stopped. Is there an aircraft coming into land? No, so that means it's just waiting for clearance. And it's got clearance. Great. I'm trying to figure out which airport this is, but I've no clue which airport. There we go. It's trundling. Don't know, with no flaps, because I think this thing has no flaps. Let's watch this thing take off, or fail to do so. It definitely will take off, I mean. It's an AI aircraft, so. I don't believe this to be JFK. Ooh, almost tail strike there. Actually, this might be JFK. Yeah, this is actually JFK. So we're using that runway. Okay. There's the Pacific Airlines. Pacific
Air
Airlines.
Air France 1123 heavy. Contact New York Center on 121.125. 121.125 for Air France 1123 heavy.
And cont.
New York Center, Air France 1123.
I think
heavy.
That world travel aircraft 8, is coming into land.
Air France 1123 heavy, New York Center, roger. Altimeter 3022.
Hold on, this is on the water, literally. I've heard of airports being on the water, but never like that. Oh, this thing is coming in directly over these buildings. And I'm presuming that's the airport there. So yeah, we'll be landing at that airport. I can assume. And if you look around here, this aircraft is flying in over Manhattan. I believe. Yeah, it is. If you look, there's a cruise ship, there's the Empire State, the Chrysler building, the gear is down. So wait a second, which runway is that? If we have to fly in over that, it's going to get complicated. I can tell you that. Also, why do you not use flaps, mate? Yeah, maybe I should do that. Come in with no flaps. It's going to be wonderful. That aircraft is landing there. Wait, which one way do we... I have clearance to land at, actually. Let's just kind of pull up. Turn left, expect IS runway 4 right. So this is where we will be landing, I believe. Hopefully this... Oh, well, actually, the L-1011 can land quite easily and safely. However, this aircraft is coming in too high. Because this is a 70... Oh, there's the flat. Are you only supposed to lower the flaps when you're that close in? I didn't know that, but... And that's where the aircraft is. I think shortly they should tell us to turn. I mean, if this aircraft came in flying in... Maybe that's the kind of route we're going to take, but I have no idea. You can see there's quite a bit of air traffic. I almost said LaGuardia. No, this is JFK. LaGuardia looks different. I know LaGuardia looks different. And LaGuardia is kind of over there somewhere. I think that might be LaGuardia.
Air France 1123 heavy. Contact New York Center on 118.975.
Knowledge?
118.975 for Air France 1123 heavy.
And tune contact.
New York Center, Air France 1123 heavy with you 8000.
Air France 1123 heavy, New York Center, Roger. Altimeter 3.
See, this thing is coming in perfectly on the glide slope.
Air France 1123 heavy, turn right heading 315, airway 2716.
You've done a knoll, but not turn until this aircraft's on you.
Turn right heading 315, Air France 1123 heavy.
Well, they'll tell me to expedite the heading.
Turn left heading 260, proceed on course. Airway 2716.
Yeah, this thing is coming in too high. Yeah, see, this might come in a bit lower.
Air France 1123 heavy, turn right heading 345. Air France 1123 heavy, turn right heading 345. Send and maintain 1500.
Don't worry.
Airway 2716.
Look at that, no flare at all.
Turn right heading 345. Descend and maintain.
I thought they'd just have the nose up until the reversers pop.
Climb and maintain flight level 220, airway 2716.
Heading 345, altitude 1500, vertical speed 3000, speed 175. To me, that's kind of the optimum approach. I don't know why I'm. Maybe that's the speed I use when you go or something. As you can see, we're...
Air France 1123 heavy. Contact McGuire. Approach on 120.25.
Roger.
Going to 120.25. Air France 1123 heavy.
I'm extending the flaps another stage.
McGuire, approach. Air France 1123 heavy is at 6,000, descending 1,500.
Air France 1123 heavy, McGuire approach, roger, altimeter 3022.
Flaps out another setting. Just knowing that at 175 this thing will need to be at full flaps. Maybe in real life you wouldn't kind of have the flaps up this early, but I'm not an expert. Right, now the nose is being... go for a bit more invasive air brakes. I'm about to call them speed brakes. So actually, wait, there we go. It's kind of starting to level out. Something with this aircraft should be interesting. Of course, what I'm noticing is a few tri-jets, don't have reverses on the rear engine. This one does, for example. This one does, and so does the DC-10 and the MD-11, for example, the Tupolev 154. It only has reverses on the two side engines. I can kind of understand why, but... So, for example, the Tupolev usually uses the bucket reversers. Overshot, so... pull in those flaps. What is that current airspeed? Oh god, well below what it was supposed to be at, so. Go up another stage of flaps. And coming up 4x speed. Yeah, I think that's good.
Required approach.
Does it actually?
Orbit 9 4 7.
We're flying at full flaps.
Roger. Altimeter 3.
Evo probably pointing out flaws, but what? Don't care.
Air France 1123.
Turn left, heading 315. Air France 1123, heavy.
There we go, 315. Now this is where things are going to get interesting, because of course...
Air France 11.
Oh god, that's us.
Heavy, you are 2-3 miles south. Turn right, heading 015. Climb and maintain 1,500. Cleared ILS, runway 4, right, approach. Maintain 1,500 until established on the localized.
Turn right, heading 015. Climb and maintain 1,500. Cleared ILS, runway 4, right, approach. Maintain 1,500 until established. Tower on 123.9er. Air France 1123, heavy. Kennedy Tower, Air France 1123, heavy, is 23 miles south. Inbound ILS, runway 4, right approach. Air France 1123, heavy, Kennedy Tower, fly straight in, runway 4, right, altimeter 3021. Fly straight in, runway 4, right, Air France 1123, heavy.
Altitude, how I'm going, we're slightly above. Anyway, I think we're doing it. We've been clear to fly in, but I'm not sure. You know, option simulation. Well, time to get out the good old phone. You can see there are no flaps here and here because of the engines. At least that's what I think. That's what I think. Search. That's JFK. So which is runway 4 right then? Is it this? Yep, actually good. I know what runway I'm coming into. Alright, good. Request airport direction.
Kennedy Tower, Air France 1123, heavy, is unfamiliar with the area. Request directions to the airport. Air France 1123, heavy, airport is 1 o'clock, 15 miles.
Heading is safe, I can. It's not gonna be bad if they maintain. this is quite intense. Zoom in. There it is, we're going to the non-sticky altitude. Close enough for my liking. Hear that? Gear down, gear door closing, gear down and locked. That's the one we were coming in to land on. As you can see, turbulence. Roussillon is just a very limited in terms of actual usefulness. I'm going to turn just a bit. See, the wings will kind of automatically level out. But I'm going to leave auto throttle on until I'm just above the runway. I don't know if I said auto throttle, okay. It's like, did I say altitude hold? I hope I didn't, because that would be a smart thing to say. I'm just working on coming into land smoothly. No hands yet, the aircraft rights itself. I'm not sure if I should say, well, that's understandable, or if that's just confusing as heck. Also, Igor, I landed on the 747 at Kaitak. Not video, but I will probably do a flight to Kaitak just to annoy you. Fasten seatbelt signs. I don't need to worry about those because they're still on from takeoff. So, for example, the auto throttle is still enabled. So, you know, Igor might be saying this is too fast. Oh god, what?
Approaching 04.
Thanks,
right.
Mate, but that's not my biggest concern at the moment. What the heck? Oh, come on, just work with me. Otherwise, we're all going to die. That's probably not that much of an overstatement. Is this thing that has those little guidey lights? That tells you how you're. Tells you if you're too high or. It's really bad, I can't... I'm pausing to get this thing properly lined up. There. Come on. Alright. Got engine cut off. And we're coming in too high, so we're going to... do a bit of the good old quick descent and starting it. And flare. Oh, almost started ascending again, so. Oh, yep. Close window, flaps up. Probably wouldn't pull up the flaps.
Air France 1123, heavy exit runway when able.
Let's zoom in. Oh, found a button that zooms in.
4,000. 1,000 feet remaining.
No worries. We're basically down on the runway. Do we have any aircraft in the air nearby?
3,000 feet remaining.
Don't worry, I'm just turn off here. This is my exit. Yeah, I think that was a fairly smooth landing. It could
Air France 1123 Heavy, exit runway when able.
Roger that.
Runway Air France 1123 Heavy, contact ground on 121.65.
Acknowledge.
Going to 121.65. Air France 1123 Heavy. Kennedy ground, Air France 1123 Heavy, request taxi to the gate. Air France 1123 Heavy, taxi to gate Echo 11, using taxiway Foxtrot Alpha Golf Lima Alpha Lima Alpha.
Acknowledge.
Taxiing to gate Echo 11 via taxiway Foxtrot Alpha Foxtrot Alpha Golf Lima Alpha Lima Alpha. Air France 1123 Heavy.
Actually turning so much the aircraft is leaning. No, okay, good. Yeah, you can see that's the JFK tower there, isn't it? We're not stopping anybody from taking off, at least. However, I do think they could have given us that runway because it's slightly longer and would have made it easier for me to land. But hey, I could still land. That was one of my smoother landings. I think it would have been just misleading. Like, oh, that's very smooth. I'm not sure if that's at the gear buckling level, but yeah. Also, for example, let me just mention something about the MD-11. It has one of the fastest landing speeds. Because to make it more aerodynamic, because basically it's a stretched DC-10, but they decided to shrink the tails, those that are just currently moving around, to reduce drag and make it more aerodynamic. But of course, that means that lower
approaching
speed
doesn't provide
as much
right
control.
Approaching two
I believe
right.
This happened at
approaching two right.
This happened at twice, once at Narita with a FedEx aircraft, and previously somewhere else. I think it was somewhere in New York, I believe, but no clue where, and or what exact airport and when. But basically, oh, they've got a King Air and a CRJ 700. CRJ is coming into land. Air traffic. I wish to view air traffic. Yep, that's the one coming into land. I wonder if we'll be able to. You know, it's landing at that runway over there, so we might be able to see it. And meanwhile, here I am, just taxiing. La la la, nothing to see here. But you can see that aircraft coming in with flaps. With flaps at the ready. I'm just gonna get a good landing view set up. Come on, move your aircraft. Move. Look over there. Should be able to see. Yeah, there's a CRJ. So technically it can see us as well. Which is why I'm actually going to. Okay. It probably can see us, but, you know. It should see us in this open tarmac, on this open area of tarmac. Oh, so I'm going onto the grass. There's that aircraft, I think. That's a Pacifica. That seems to be in Orbit Airlines. So it's coming into land. CRJ is on. Yep, there you go. See it there? It's 1.6 nautical miles away. And, jeez, that was much higher than my landing. The reversers haven't kicked in yet. Now they have. Yeah, that is a different aircraft there. But yeah, that thing stopped very quickly. I just wonder if we'll be able to see us. 901 feet. Beechcraft King Air. 8.6 nautical miles. Don't think that's... Yeah, please don't tell me to hold position, caution, other traffic. Okay, the CRJ is turning off. Yep, there it is, actually. So that means... It should be... Oh no, because... We're kind of like a bit of an above, so... Just gun the engines a bit. I want to see this aircraft just emerging from behind that brick terminal.
On taxiway, on taxiway.
Request taxi to the gate.
Orbit 9477, taxi to gate Delta 23.
Oh, come on.
Taxiway November, Papa, Bravo,
should
Lima,
definitely
Alpha, Hotel.
Taxiing to gate Delta 23 using taxiway November, Papa, Bravo, Lima, Alpha, Hotel. Orbit 9477.
Why is it not turned enough? I mean, the thing is almost on the same taxiway as it is. Seriously. This is getting on my nerves. Look. Oh, there we are. We're just blending in. Okay, I'm happy. Alright, let's see. Air traffic. It was a King Air, I believe, about to land. It was a Baron. Oh no, the King Air has just landed. Okay, close the window. See, there's the CRJ. And we're going to park there and open all the doors and shut down all the engines. There we go. That was, I think, one of my better landings. So now I've got a technique that I'm going to use. Of course, you know, maybe that technique is only works in this aircraft, but who knows. Yeah, that sign is about to get clipped by a jet. Oh no, it's not. Okay, I think those signs are, to some extent, designed to not be able to get hit by jet engines. But that means that we set lower down. If you look over there, you can see the CRJ. I don't know why the sound randomly quits. Air traffic. Yep, just la 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 la. Well, if I press Shift E2. Yep, Shift E4. Yeah, I'm just opening all the exits. And look, probably. Should just power down these engines first. Oh yeah, I'm parking there. Okay, hold engines on. Going to activate slew mode. Well, if that thing is going to go and start doing it, I don't know. Let's wait for anything. I'm not sure if I'm going to come in here.
Yep,
it's good.
Short of runway 13, right.
Contact tower on 119.11 ready. Taxi, hold short runway 13.
Reverse it still. I don't know what that where that guy points. Are they using it as a diving point? So those are the fire things. Yep, there we go. I know that. So anyway, guys, that was a flight from Charles de Gaulle in Paris to JFK Airport in New York with an Air France L-1011. I'm Bob from 25. Goodbye.